Hey guys, it's Austin here, and today we're gonna do a Be a Pro in NHL 21. Why the other one just ended was because I did a different one, but my friend had to be a jerk and call me on Instagram, so I couldn't finish it because he decides to be a jerkle, because he is one. So you guys can see his username should be here, but I unfriended him on PlayStation because he wants to be a jerk, and my brother just found a block button on Instagram, so then he won't be a jerk and call me. So, let you guys listen to this, because he's a jerk. I guess I'm not joking, he actually is one. This looks cool.
NHL Super Agent Taylor Mackey joins us here on the line, who represents the hottest, most anticipated prospect in years. Taylor, give us the 411 on the kid here.
Hey, morning, James. Well, look, you may not believe this, but the kid's up here on Carter Lake.
What?
Playing pickup, yeah, with a bunch of other kids. Just, it's a beautiful day.
Pricey pond hockey you got going there.
Yeah, I suppose it is. But look, that's how much this kid loves the game, man.
Well, just safety first up there. Now,
of course.
I gotta ask you, we've seen the scouting reports, we've seen the highlights, but we know about the player. But tell me more about the person. What's this rookie really like?
Yeah, sure, James. Let's begin by telling your listeners at home the kid's name.
We're gonna be a gold, guys. No, actually, we're gonna be a D-man. We're gonna be our main sport is gonna be lefty, number 5. All the way down we go. We're gonna be 171 pounds. Sometimes big Canada, yes, I'll take that. Yeah. I'll do the behavior and all that in between the videos. Just to let you guys know. So do we be a defenseman? Like Suda and Chris Pronger. Offense, like Carson and that guy. Enforcer or two-way. We're gonna start in the Memorial Cup. We're gonna go to the OHL. We're gonna go. No, we're gonna go to the Key, and we're gonna go on Lafreniere's team, Rimouski, Oceanic. That's what I call him, guys. Rimouski Oceanic. We're gonna do 3 minute periods. That's all the way down there. All star on difficulty, dynamic high. I don't know why. Gameplay sliders. I won't worry about that. I will probably do that between videos as well. So if there's a tiebreaker, it's gonna be a shootout like right away. Season overtime loss or shootout, whatever you want to call it. It's gonna be. You're gonna get 0 points for it. Tie your jerseys are on. There we go. Let's do it!
Trophy, Ray Ferraro. Does that conjure up some memories there for you?
Yeah, you bet it does. What an awesome time in your career. It's the most important games that you've played in your life, really, until that time. And now for most of these players, it'll be the biggest games they ever play. But there's also NHL scouts here. There's draft rankings on the line. This is a fantastic tournament to play in.
1983 has been a few years. You still remember the moment, though?
I do, because as it turned out, that's the only tournament we ever won, the only one I was ever on the winning side of.
Well, let's look at this year's edition, because what are the players in line?
Let's get back skating. Put that up there. Ottawa is in this. I guess depends on what week is going on. I guess. Conversation with agent. Hey Austin, you're on the verge of being drafted into the NHL. When you get drafted, it depends on how well you do in this tournament. So go out there and impress the scouts with your skills. I think you can go first of all. Just the same questions, I'm going to do that one. That's the spirit, Austin. Your family and I will support you. We'll all support you. You will succeed and we'll be there for you. Oh, don't forget, okay. Alright. I actually look good in a Rimouski jersey. Oh, now we got a conversation with my coach. Hey Austin, how are you doing? I just wanted to talk with you regarding this first tournament game. You understand it's a big deal for the team, right? Of course. Okay. I'm gonna go with that one. Great to hear you, Austin. I want you to help lead the team to victory in our next game. I need you to give it all you got. Sure, I will. I have to win the next game for the Rimouski Oceanic. I'm usually a winner. Guys, when I do a be a pro in any NHL game, like NHL 18, 19, 20, 16, 15. I'm always a winner.
Here we bring Ray Ferraro back into the fold, and boy, the scout cam should be on full display tonight, won't they?
Yeah, there'll be a bunch of people wearing black jackets. That's what the scouts wear, and they'll be sitting up in the corners of the rink watching these players really closely. Now, they've got a book pretty much on every player by this point in the season, but these are critical games to watch how they'll play against the very best competition. This absolutely will help determine where a player will go in the draft.
Oh, I'm sure they're playing in those bright lights, and how do you respond? And, you know, one of the other players that a lot of people have been talking about.
Lafreniere's an 82, guys. He's a high elite. Holy. Look at those shot. That shot is insane. Well, we're second line D-man, and we're the highest overall out of the D-man. We got it. Corden Ellis in there, and Creed Jones backing them up. I guess he can draft. St. Louis and not draft. I forgot where my guy's from, guys. Hold on, just give me a second. Oh, wait, it won't even change. Okay. I'm already a medium elite, and I haven't even done my first game yet, guys. So, let's play this next game. Let's use it all custom. I don't know what the heck is going on here. So, a home, even a work. Alright, so all-star, 3-minute period, started. So we have to win the next game. We have to win this game. There's already a goal. We already got a goal, guys. Super early in the game. I think that's a little bit insane.
Grabs the puck. Portland's got it along the wall. And he can't hang on after that hit. Hooks their way to zone end. Takes control of the puck. And scores. They tie it. They stays in the entire time.
That hurts, guys. My coach is gonna probably get out of that game. Oh, I have to be on this side. Ew.
Rimouski's won the draw. Into the attacking area from the left side. The WinterHawks take it across the blue.
They're offside.
Offside is the call. We'll have a face-off just outside the offensive zone. James Sabalski, Ray Ferraro, with you here in the early going of this period. It's all tied up. The WinterHawks win the draw here in the neutral zone. Portland's got a hold of the puck. And he handles a cross-ice pass. Puck picked up in the open ice.
Oh, jeez. No.
Well,
guys, the Portland WinterHawks are actually waking up.
They've got to continue to push. The WinterHawks win the faceoff. Over the line they come. Oceanic's gain possession along the boards. The WinterHawks.
I have to get back. Go back.
Portland's got the puck against the boards. The WinterHawks look to play it behind the cage. Move it to the middle. Oh, what a missed chance that was.
Yeah, he's got to make a better play.
Scores!
we get? So we got literally an 82.
Coach over there on the bench next to you. He wants something to happen, somebody to take the lead, and so he's gone down to his youngest player, the rookie, to see if his young legs can spark a lethargic team.
So guys, we got an 82 medium, well, highly, I should say. I'm offside. Come on.
Going to the frame. The WinterHawks have been getting solid offensive contributions, leading 3-1. Off the try. Nice job locking up his opponent. Here he is in front. Can't connect. Nice feed from the right wing. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone. In a dangerous spot. He makes a good save here.
I don't get this, guys. How is Portland so good?
And a pretty good one at that. Oceanic's got a hold of it against the wall.
There you go.
Rimouski's got the puck along the wall. Scrum along the boards. The WinterHawks have it from their own end. Exploring options here inside the defensive zone.
What are we doing? You guys, these fingers are going pretty quickly. Guys, we don't need penalties right now. We're already down.
It's been a tightly contested affair thus far as the period comes to an end.
Guys, my coach isn't going to be happy and we're going to lose. Holy, guys, look at the time going down.
Receives the pass. Portland's moving it along the wing.
Okay, guys.
Uses the force on that hit. Sends it across the ice.
I should be the ice.
Oceanic's in now. And he slides it quickly to Austin. Hammers a shot, and he says no. Rocks on the play. Proceeding to get into the attacking area. Sight of the puck to make the second save.
Okay, now they're going to score again.
Past the halfway mark in this period, Portland's got a little more jump in their step tonight.
Yeah, guys, we're going to lose.
Taken by Bergeron. A howitzer turns them away. Puck possession so critical. Another faceoff coming up here. Oceanic's got it in the offensive zone. Gets it out of his own end. Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. Nice zone entry from the middle. Here's the pass. Misses wide of the net.
Not going to get many better chances from that. Dead center, right this spot.
And they move the puck out of harm's way. Grabs it in his own end. Quick feed to a left.
Guys, we don't need penalties out here. Guys, we're done. Be all of them. Anyway, at least I have more shots. More hits.
Game one of the Memorial Cup in the book. We bring back Ray Ferraro. And Ray, what you making a kid out there?
Not bad. I mean, I know he'll be disappointed because it's the first game of the tournament and you really want to start kind of with a bang, and he didn't. There were some decent moments for him, but the scouts were kind of buzzing a little bit that they believe there's another gear for him to hit in this tournament.
Yeah, I think when you look at where he's at and the rest of the team going forward, one of the things I wanted to also ask you.
Crap, guys. Not looking good. Austin, just a quick question. How do you feel with this being your first tournament game? Felt okay, a bit overwhelmed by the momentum, but always supported by my team family. No big deal actually. I dream of hosting the Stanley Cup someday. Ooh. I'm gonna do team one. What do you think is more important? Your teammates' support or your coach guidance? The coach is important, obviously, but my teammates are really supporting me right now. Or I think both are equal important to me right now. Completely. Good luck, Austin. Sure. Goodbye. Yeah. Okay. did we move up anywhere? No, we didn't. We're the highest D-man, guys, and we're not even on the first D-pair. That's a little bit weird. So, that's going to be it for this one. If you did enjoy, hit that like button, subscribe down below, and hit that little bell so you don't miss out on a future video. And we'll see you guys later. Episode 2 will be recorded. I don't know when, but it will be recorded. Oh, once again, hit the like button, subscribe down below. Hit that little bell so you don't miss out on a future video. And we'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.